God's words.
那我们先来又回到我们的启示录第二十一章。
So we'll return back to Revelations, chapter 22.
那这从第三节一直到第八节，有三次的宣告。
From verse 3 to verse 8, there are three proclamations.
哎，你只是用听的哈，约翰也是用听的，就听到说到底里面是什么情况。
And so,you could just listen, as John had also listened, to understand the situation.
那在这一段里面呢，坐宝座的开始讲话。
And so within this context, the one who sat on the throne began to speak.
在第四章、第五章开始的时候，他有出现，但是都一直没有讲。
In the beginning, at chapter 4 and chapter 5, that he appeared, however, he never spoke.
那在这里呢，那个坐宝座的讲话了。
But then at this point, the one who sat on the throne began to speak.
好，那一开始呢，第三节。
In verse 3.
说看哪、啊，神的帐幕在人间。
He said that, look, verse 23. And I heard a loud voice from heaven saying, "Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men."
哎，神真正的跟人同住了。
And that He is right now going to be with His people.
哎，那神跟人同住之后
，And that after He be with His people,
那。我们就成为他的子民，他要亲自跟我们同在。
That he will be his that they will be his people and that he will be with them.
他要做做我们的神呢、啊。
And that he will become our God.
那神就在旁边呢、哦。
And God will be right beside us.
是真正的，就是这个是在信仰上面是一个过程的。
In terms of faith, this would be a journey.
有时候我们听神听很多。
Quite often we hear about God so often.
那真正如果真的神在你旁边。
However, if God is truly right beside you.
这里有句话就说，以前的事都过去了。
And here it says that, verse 4, that former things have passed away.
以前的是什么事呢？
What would be the former things?
眼泪
and that is tears,
死亡
death,
悲哀
sorrow,
哭嚎
crying,
疼痛
and pain.
这是我们人间，我们每天都会经历的。
And these are things that we experience quite often on a daily basis.
那如果神到最后真的跟我们同在了
that if indeed God is with us at the end,
神会擦我们眼泪的。
That God will be the one wiping away our tears.
我们有时候信徒也会受苦啊。
And so, as believers, we will also endure suffering.
有时候我们真的神擦我们眼泪，但是呢，怎么？你好像神又跑掉了，即使是你跑掉了，那你又哭起来了啊，又来找神了，神又擦你眼泪，所以擦来擦去还是一直在擦。
That if God is the one who's wiping away your tears, you would actually run away and then come back to God again for Him to wipe away your tears, and this cycle will repeat itself.
好像小朋友一样嘛。
Just as you're like little kids.
他哭了啊，回来妈妈擦擦眼泪啊，就出去了又回来。
That after the kid cry, the kid will return back home. The mother will wipe away the tears, but then the kid will also run away outside of home again.
到最后我们会完全。
At the end, we shall become perfect.
神一擦就不会再流了。
That after the Lord wipe away the tears, then the tears will no longer flow.
所以我们的神是擦眼泪的神。
Our God is the God who wipe away tears.
神当然你可以布道会常以前常讲，就是神是大医生啊，神是什么最大的心理智商啊。如果你但是这里讲的是神专门擦眼泪，神用什么手帕、卫生纸？不用了。
And so, previously in evangelical services, we would quite often say that God is the great physician, the great psychiatrist, and that He will, right now, as we say, will wipe away your tears. What kind of things that He will wipe away the tears with? Would it be napkins or Kleenex?
那这里蛮有趣的，他说擦去他们一切的眼泪。
But then in verse 4, rather interesting that here it says that wipe that God will wipe away every tear from their eyes.
你笑到腰都弯了，流泪了，神会给你擦去。
So,
你高兴，神跟你同在；你悲伤，神会擦眼泪。
Perhaps that you're so happy that you laugh to the point of shedding tears, God will wipe away those tears. Or even when you're so sorrowful that you have tears, God will also wipe away those tears.
这是在圣城里面的情况是这样。
This would be the situation right within the holy city.
好，接下来第五节哈。
Verse five.
坐宝座的自己又宣告了。
Then he who sat on the throne and said,
看哪、啊，我将一切都更新了。
Behold, I make all things new.
并且他还特别说要写下来。
And he said to me, write these things down.
神自己保证，并且自己说这些话是可信的，是真实的。
And God is the one who guaranteed that these words are true and faithful.
好，第六节。
Verse six.
他又讲啊。
And he said to me,
这个是做宝座的，在这里是第三次的宣告。
And so this is the third proclamation by the one who sat on the throne.
说成了。
It is done.
这个成呢是说变成了。
And that it is done because it has transformed to be so.
所以这个时候是完全的教会完全的成那个完全了。
And so at this point, the church has been perfected.
然后呢又回到了第一章的宣告。
And then we turn back to the proclamation recorded in chapter 1.
神就说这里说我是阿拉法，我是 Omega， 我是初，我是终。
The God proclaimed that He is the Alpha, He is the Omega, He is the beginning, He is the end。
在一章八节有这样的一个同样的叙述。
In chapter 1 verse 8, there it recites the same description。
那现在要把生命的水泉的水白白赐给我们。
And at this point, He will give the fountain of the water of life freely。
那第七节
Verse 7,
这个得胜的要接受这些为产业呢。
And he who overcomes shall inherit all things.
然后呢，一样的，我们做他的子民，他做我们的神。
By the same token, that if we become his people, we will become his children.
这是在那个圣城里面的情况。
And these are the situation residing within the holy city.
那我们看第九节
Let's turn to verse 9.
现在要去看看到底里面是什么。
So we are to witness what really contains within.
进不去
And we cannot enter.
你用刚早上我们有谈到你用怎么样用现在很难啊。现在当然可以啊，现在科技的话，你就打一个卫星上去嘛。
And so as we know right now, it'll be pretty easy because as long as we send a text over.
好了。那一般人可能不可能，但在灵里面根本没办法。
And so, within that normally it will not be possible.
那我们看第九节
Verse 9.
这里呢，拿着七个金碗，盛满末后七灾的七位天使中，有一位来对我说。
Then one of the seven angels who had the seven bowls filled with the seven last plagues came to me and talked with me.
哇，这个介绍的很长
And so this introduction seems quite long.
第一个，我们来看末后七灾。
First, we see that it is the seven last plagues.
末后七灾是世界要末了之前有七个灾。对，这个灾是很大的。
So the seven last plagues refer to how before the end of the world there shall be seven plagues.
那这个七灾呢是神。以七个天使，他手里拿着七个碗，这个金碗里面是圣的神的愤怒。
And so these last plagues will be contained within seven bowls, and these seven bowls will have God's wrath contained within.
那因为神很生气啦。
Because due to the extreme wrath from God.
这是神一路来很少生气，根本没有生气过。
That within this entire journey,God never became indignant.
神最后的那个 wrath, 就那个 okay, 最后的生气是用七碗倒。
That at the end, God will manifest his wrath by pouring these seven, what was contained within these seven bowls onto us.
在旧约里面就一直重复的说 神大而可畏的日子，大而可畏的日子，一直讲啊。
And also it's been recorded in the Old Testament that the great and fearful awesome day of God, and it has been continuously mentioned.
那个小时候，那个如果小孩子调皮啊，那个乡下的妈妈说：“把他打死。”其实都没有啊。
It seems like
我要打你了。
When we're young,
一直要打到他已经长大了，还没有打过一次。
When we're young, those mothers in the countryside would probably say that, "Oh, I will, punish you to the point of death." But then, ever since young, the mother never punished the child.
神实在是被人欺负得很厉害。
That God had been a bully by men all this time.
那但是到最后哈，叫世界末日以前呢，有七大灾。
Prior to the end of the world, that there shall be seven plagues.
那这是记载在第十六章。
It's been recorded in verse 16.
嗯，最后一灾倒下来的时候，第七碗倒下来的时候。
That at the last plague, that is the downpour of the seventh bowl.
那时候呢是空前的大地震啊。
That there shall be earthquake that never been seen before.
以那个大巴比伦城所象征的这个世界呢，那个大城呢、啊。不是说房子倒啊，或是什么，整个城裂作三段。但是到最后，圣经说一个大响声，世界就过去了。
I've been reflected that the great Babylon as reflecting what is of this world. It's that it will have this earthquake that not only going to shake down houses, but rather the entire city will be split into three parts.
那这个。那个降七灾的这个七个天使当中的一位
，that the seven angels, the whom who were pouring down these seven plagues, among them one of them,
哎，他手里还拿着金碗
，and he still had the golden bowl with him,
表示说还没去到了
，that is he has yet to pour down this.
他来跟约翰说
，and he came to speak with John,
说到我这里来
，that come to me.
到哪里去
？Where shall John go？
当然，天使是在灵界里面，要到灵界里面去。
Of course, angel reside within the spiritual realm, and therefore, he was to enter into the spiritual realm.
他说：“你来我这里呢，我要将心腹，就是羔羊的妻，指示给你看，指给你看。
”And here he said that I will show you the bride, the Lamb's wife.
你要看心腹，一定要有天使的指示啊，不然看不出来。
That if you want to see the bride, that you shall have the instruction from the angel, or else you cannot see.
今天早上我们有讲过，你平常的你站在那个圣城前面，你看不出来，为什么？你身高多高？两米好不好？两米就很高了嘛。
As we mentioned earlier, that if you were to be right in front of the holy city, looking upon its wall, maybe perhaps you are at most 2 meters tall.
好，给你三米了。现在世界没有三米的，两米都有了，三米的。
Perhaps you are 3 meters tall, even though there's no such type of person.
有够高的了。
And you know you would be tall enough.
那个圣城呢是2304公里呀、啊。
However, the wall of the city is actually 2400 kilometers high.
正常人、哦、如果没有什么远视，没有什么近视，你眼睛不错的30公里以外的东西看已经看不清了。
And so for normal people, if you're without being farsighted or short or nearsighted, you can't really tell what is about 30 kilometers away.
好，所以要去看圣城，不是平常人可以看得到的。
And so to be able to witness the holy city will not be able to be witnessed by normal people.
你用正常人的眼睛，正常人的眼光，绝对看不看，你只看到一片大墙啊。
So if you use the normal eyesight of people, then you would only see a giant wall.
好，那我们来看第十节哈。
Turn to verse 10.
来
，verse 10, and he carried me away in the spirit to a great and high mountain, and showed me the great city of the holy Jerusalem descending out.Of heaven from God.
英文翻得很好，中文说我被圣灵感动，其实不是被圣灵感动，而是什么？ 英文是这个是对的，在灵里面。
And so in
the spirit, huh?
Chinese, it had been translated into that he had been moved in by the Holy Spirit, but rather the English translation is far more faithful in saying that he was carried away in the spirit.
他被带，然后呢，被带去，然后呢，是在灵里面。
And he was carried away, but the way that he was carried away was actually in spirit.
那神把他带，那个这个天使把他带到哪里去？
So the angel carried him away.
带到一座高又大的山
，onto a great and high mountain，
一定要很大，一定要很高啊。
It has to be a mountain that's extremely tall and extremely high。
你要多高啊
？How high should this mountain be？
你要看那个城里面，你要超过那个墙才可以看得到嘛。
And so it has to be a point where it surpasses the height of the city in order to be able to look within。
如果用现在的物质界来讲的话，你要带到太空里面去啊。
In a more physical sense, you need to bring this person all the way into the outer space.
但是是在灵里面，这告诉我们要在属灵的高度里面才看得到。
And since this is within the spirit, this is to symbolize that we must be at the height of our spirituality in order to be able to witness what's within.
一般是这样，你什么样的位置看什么样的东西。
And normally, depending on your position, you'll be able to see the things that you see with because of that position.
小孩子看东西都很大。
And so for little kids, for them to see things, it will seem quite often very big.
我记得我小学的时候，毕业之后，我感觉那个印象里面感觉那个小学那个学校啊，那个什么校园很大，操场很大。校门很大。
When I was young, I remember that the elementary school that I was at, the campus seemed rather large, and the entire school seemed rather vast in expanse.
三十年不小心从那边经过，奇怪，这个是怎么？好像小学怎么缩水了
？But then, after about 30 some years that I passed by, I felt like the entire elementary school shrank.
其实不是，因为你那个时候太小嘛。
Because you were only so young back then.
所以你看到都是老师都是大人啊，后来一看，怎么老师那么小？
And when you were young, you saw how the teachers or the principals seemed rather large. But right now, after you've grown, it seems like they're rather small.
你不在灵里面被带到属灵的高度里，你看不到里面的。
That without being on top of the spiritual height, you cannot witness what contained within.
要带到高山啊。
Rather, you need to be brought onto a high mountain.
然后呢，看什么呢？
What are you to see?
同样的，要将那由神那里从天而降的圣城新耶路撒冷要指给约翰看。
That on the top of this mountain, this entire New Jerusalem shall be pointed to John.
一定要记住。这个圣城不是你来造，我来造，这本来神的计划在那里。
And so this entire holy city is not for you or I to construct, rather what contains within would be the plan of God.
最后教会完成的、成全的那个教会是神赐下来的。
That at the end, the finishing and the perfection of the entire church will be due to the God's work.
不是人做的。
It's not something that mankind can complete.
你看第二节也是这样讲。
Verse 2 also mentioned the same thing.
他是看到圣城新耶路撒冷由神那里从天而降，是天降的。
And so here it says that the New Jerusalem coming down out of heaven from God. So we can see that this Jerusalem descended from heaven.
第十节也是一样，从天降的。
And verse 10 also mentioned the same thing, that this Jerusalem descended out of heaven.
但是当然我们要配合，我们要跟你所得到的恩典相称。
Of course, as human beings, we need to be able to be worthy of this grace.
所以你要那么高度才能够看到这个圣城里面。
That is, you need to match the height of the wall in order to be able to witness what contained within.
来，我们看第十节哈。
Verse 10.
现在看到了哈。
That we can witness this.
城中有什么？
What is within the holy city?
第一个有。
First thing,
有神的荣耀。
That contained within would be the glory of God.
好，我们看第十二节。
Verse 12.
第二个有。
That is the second things within.
有高大的墙。
That there would be great and high wall.
哎，这我们已经早上看过了哈。
And we have also discussed this in the morning.
这个有够高，有够有够大。
That it will be tall enough, it will be high enough.
好，接下来第三个。
And then in verse 3.
有十二个门。
That there will be 12 gates.
好，那我们就用这样子来看看到底里面是什么。
And so with this, we need to examine what would be really contained within.
哎，先从门开始哦。
Let's look at the, let's discuss about the gates.
哎，有十二个门，然后接下来是门上有十二位天使。
That there will be 12 gates, and on the gates there will be 12 angels.
你是从外面看的嘛，哈。
So you are looking from outside.
有十二个门。
That there will be 12 gates.
那门上面呢，你看到有天使。
And on top of the gate, there will be 12 angels.
天使做什么？
What was the purpose of these angels?
天使是侍奉的嘛，哈。
These angels were to serve.
是保护的嘛。
They were to protect.
那个，我们来看一节圣经，哈，那个。
Turn to verse.
马太福音
Matthew、
在马太福音里面来看十八章
Verse chapter 18
十八章那个一开始呢是主耶稣说那个不要轻看小孩子、
In the beginning Lord Jesus said that do not look down upon the little kids
对那个，因为有人说，问呐、啊，说天国里谁最大
？Because somebody asked, what, who will be the greatest within heavenly kingdom?
这个是人间都是这样的。
And within human society, would always behave in the same way.
就是我们从小就是活在一个比较的社会里面。
That ever since we're young, we live in a society in which we compare.
都是比谁最大，第一名。最高、最好、最棒、最漂亮，
We will compete
都是这样
as who will be the number one, who will be the greatest, and who will be the most beautiful. And ever since we're young, we compete in such manner.
那门徒呢？头呢？可能没想清楚。
But then for these disciples, perhaps they didn't really think about this clearly.
他问了、问主耶稣，直接问：哎，以后去天国谁第一名啊？
They、
谁最棒啊？
Directly asked Lord Jesus Christ, "Oh, when we enter into heavenly kingdom, who would be the greatest?"
那主耶稣就叫一个小孩子来。
Then Lord Jesus Christ called upon a little child.
叫小孩子，他们绝对不会想些怎么会叫一个小孩呢
？They would probably never consider why the Lord had called upon a little child.
耶稣说你们要回转。
Jesus said that you need to be converted and become as little children.
如果不变成小孩子，进不了天国。
That you will by no means enter into heavenly kingdom if you do not do so.
所以要谦卑自己。
And so, you are to humble yourself.
好，小孩子是在当时社会人家看不起的。
And so, for little children, they were look down upon and despised within a society.
好，那也是常常被欺负的。
And that they were quite often bullied.
那我们来看第十节。
And let's read verse 10.
从小孩子变成小子，哈。
And that you shall from little children, you will become little ones.
来第十节
，verse ten. Take heed that you do not despise one of these little ones, for I say to you that in heaven the angels always see the face of my Father who is in heaven.
主耶稣那个警告那些就是大人物啊。
That Lord Jesus Christ was warning those major figures within the society,
甚至是当时的门徒、
and even those disciples back then.
你们要小心哦。
That you must take heed.
不可轻看这小子里的一个。
And you do not despise one of these little ones.
这个小子不一定是身体小，而是年纪小啊。
And these little ones will not be necessarily small in stature or in age.
在当时的小子，就是人家看不起的，他可能是无家可归，或是根本没有职业的，或是在飘荡的哈。
And so the little ones here would not just be those, but rather can be those who are homeless, who are sojourners, and who just travel about.
也就是说这个世界人家看不起的人、啊、
And that is they belong to a group of people that this world would despise.
但是如果他在神国里面，
Nonetheless, if that person is to reside within the heavenly kingdom,
耶稣说不要轻看他。
That you do not despise these type of people.
为什么呢？
Why not?
因为说我告诉耶稣说我告诉你们、哦、他们的使者在天上常见我天父的面。
For I say to you that in heaven their angels always see the face of my Father who is in heaven.
也就是说有保护他的天使啊。
In other words, there would be angels who would be protecting them.
有报告他情况的天使。
There would be angels who would be reporting that person's situation.
你看不起他。
That if you despise upon this person,
你欺负他。
That you bully this person.
他的天使在神面前说，这个大人物欺负这个小子。
Then their angel will report in heaven that this major figure within society is bullying this little one.
所以这个城是有天使保护的。
That this entire city has been protected by angels.
以整体来讲，我们有天使保护。
In totality, we are protected by angels.
以个别来讲，在神面前有我们的天使在常见那个我们阿爸天父的面。
From individual perspective, we also have angels in heavenly kingdom who often see the face of God.
如果我们这样想的话
，that if we think about this in this manner,
我们实在是不敢轻看别人了。
Then we dare not despise anyone.
反而你要给他一杯凉水啊。
Rather, we need to treat that person with a glass of cold water.
一杯凉水给小子啊。
That you can have a glass of cold water to the little ones.
主耶稣说也会得到报偿。
If you can do so, then you shall be rewarded.
因为他的天使在我们阿爸父面前说，这个小子得到一杯水。
Because the angels in heaven will report to our God in heaven that this little one has received the cold water.
因为在父面前，我们有天使在报告。
That in the presence of our Father, our Heavenly Father, there would be angels reporting.
那当然，如果我们做好事，我们就很高兴，拍拍手，赶快报告。
Of course, after we had completed great deeds, we would often applaud and then make reports of that.
但是万一我们黑心的话，那也就不好了。天使报告说他黑心了。
However, if you have ill intention within you, then that ill intention will also be reported.
但是在整体来讲，神会保护他的教会。
But in aggregate, God will be the one protecting His church.
所以也不可轻看教会。
So you also should not despise upon the church.
我们继续再看了哈。
Let's turn back.
有十二个天使哈在门上啊。
That there will be 12 angels at the gates.
那又写着以色列十二支派的名字。
And on top of that, there will be names of the 12 tribes.
这个城是以十二个支派的名字写的。
And that this city had been written down with the name of the 12 tribes.
那这个十二支派是代表什么？
What will be these 12 tribes represent?
我们若看回来启示录第七章一节到八节。
Let's turn back to Revelation chapter 7 from verse 1 to verse 8.
在这当中我们可以看得到以色列的十二个支派。
And so from within this passage, we see the 12 tribes of Israel.
七章
chapter 7.
我们看第四节。
Verse 4.
我听见以色列人各支派中受印的数目有144,000人。
And I heard the number of those who were sealed, 140,000 of all tribes of the children of Israel.
所以这个十二支派就是受印的这些人。
And these 12 tribes were the ones who had been sealed.
但我们知道这个受印，若从第一节九章，七章一节看，就知道这是从日出之地。从中国神在中国设立的真耶稣教会。
And so if we read the beginning of chapter 7, we can see that this will represent the true Jesus church established by God from China.
当然现在传到美国来了。
course, as of now, have been the words have been preached into the U.S.
这是从日出之地出来的。
And this is from the place where sun rose.
所以这个城是属于这些应儿之人的城。
And so the city will belong to those who have been sealed.
就是门神爱的城，圣徒的城。
And this will be the city of the disciples and city belonging to the ones whom the Lord loves.
所以这个圣城就是真耶稣教会。
So then this holy city would be true Jesus Church.
就是被应儿得到应许圣灵之人所聚集的这个教会。
And so this will be the church that had received the seal from God.
我们再接下来看十三节。
Let's turn to verse
13. 21章十三节。
Chapter 21, verse 13.
东边有三门，北边有三门，南边有三门，西边有三门。
The three gates on the east, three gates on the north, three gates on the south, and three gates on the west.
我们想说，这怎么这么啰嗦啊？如果说四方各三门，这样不好了。
And so we might consider this to be rather long-winded. Why can't you just say that? Oh, there will be three gates on four corners.Four sides.
他不要这样子。
But then they did not want to do so.
让你知道这个是很详细，并且呢，东北南西各有三，并且一一的来讲。
So you can know that this is rather detailed, and that on every side, north, east, west, south, and north, there will be gates.
这个是向四方的。
And so this is somewhat rectangular.
那我们也知道这个城是四方的。
And so we all know that this entire city would be a rectangular city.
你从各方来都可以进入。
And that regardless of the side you're trying to enter from, you will be able to enter.
向四方开的。
That it had been open to four sides.
这个是应儿之人的城。
Now this is a city belonging to those who are sealed.
有神保护，天使保护的城。
And this is a city that the Lord will protect, the angels will protect.
好，那看完门之后，再看看城哦。
So after we look at the gates, we are to explore the city.
十四节
，verse 14.
城墙有十个根基。
Now the wall of the city have 12 foundations.
这个根基很重要啊。
And so these foundations can be considered rather important.
你看这个城墙，这高到。太空里面去了。
That this entire city has been so tall that extends into space.
那个全世界最高的楼哈，迪拜啊。
And so the tallest building within on this earth will be in Dubai.
我第一次去的时候，好像在盖根基，后来慢慢的看它一天一天的盖。
And so the first time I went, they were still laying foundations, and subsequently I was able to see.That they are able to build up the buildings slowly.
那些有够高了。
And that then became tall enough.
全世界最高的。
That is the tallest buildings on earth.
其实很低啊，跟这个圣城。
But then it's actually extremely low compared to this holy city.
它那个时候才那个最高，它才八百多米而已啊。
At its tallest point, it would only be about 800 meters.
不要忘记，圣城是2304公里呀。
But then do not forget that the holy city would be 2,304 kilometers high.
好，那这个，所以这个根基很重要。
And so this would be, so this foundation would be rather important.
你这个圣城的根基，如果这个墙的根基如果不好的话，我这片墙我看这哇倒下来不是要，
And so if you
城的人都压死了。
If you do not have a good foundation for the city, then the walls will come crumbling down and smash the people within the city.
你看这个这样的四方的城哦，都长宽高一样，如果四面墙都倒往内倒的话，我看里面就死光光了。
So with this.Very box-like city, and you have these walls just kind of crumbling down. All the people within the city will just all perish.
这个根基是什么呢？
And so what would be this foundation?
这边说, 根基上有羔羊十二使徒的名字。
And that on this foundation, there were names of the 12 apostles of the Lamb.
这个就是十二使徒的名字写在那里，也就是说以他们为根基了。
And so these would have the 12, the names of the 12 apostles, and in other words, they have been used as the foundations.
那我们来看19节哈。
Let's turn to verse 19.
城墙的根基是用各样宝石修饰的。
And the foundation of the wall of the city were adorned with all kinds of precious stones.
这十二种宝石啊。
And it had been adorned with 12 types of stones.
你念一念，因为我对这个宝石不怎么内行，大家念念看到底是什么东西。
And so you can kind of read it for yourselves because I am not an expert at these gems.
这个应该是很宝贵的了，我只是这样想而已。
Of course, I would consider these to be rather precious, but that's only my conjecture.
这是真理了。
Then this is the truth.
这个是十二使徒为根基，就是使徒的教训。
And this will be the foundation will be the 12 disciples, that is the teachings from the 12 disciples.
那个保罗在以弗所书第二章，我们也知道很熟悉的，第二十节。
In Ephesians chapter 2 verse 20, there Paul had mentioned these words and that we're all very familiar with.
教会建立在使徒的根基上。
That the entire church had been built upon the foundation of the 12 disciples.
那使徒之后才先知。
And after the 12 disciples, then would be the prophets.
但是主耶稣是房角石啊。
But then Lord Jesus Christ would be the cornerstone.
这是最基础的。
And that would be the most basic.
主耶稣带来的恩典跟真理。
And that Lord Jesus Christ came, brought grace and truth with him.
那主耶稣传天国的福音。
That he came to preach the gospel of heavenly kingdom.
主耶稣的教训谁听到了？
And who had heard these teachings?
使徒
would be the apostles.
当然还有其他的人。
Of course, there would be also other people.
但是使徒听最多了，他们是跟着耶稣三年。
But then these apostles heard the most because they followed Lord Jesus Christ for 3 years.
他们有没有做笔记啊？
Do they take notes?
没有。
They didn't do so.
他们有没有录音机？
Do they have recorders?
也没有录音，也没有录影啊。
They never recorded down visually or audially.
他们只是听啊。
In terms of audio. And they only were able to listen.
但是主耶稣跟他们讲啊。
But then Lord Jesus Christ were the one telling them.
以后保惠师圣灵降下。
In the future, the counselor, Holy Spirit will come upon them.
你就会想起我对你们讲的话。
Then you will be able to recollect what I have told you.
所以很多道理是他们想回想的。
And so a lot of these teachings have been the recollection of these disciples.
你看像约翰福音哈。
Just like Gospel according to John.
第二章啊。
Chapter 2.
然后呢，第21节。
Verse 21.
这边说耶稣这话是以他的身体为殿。 那第22节，所以到他从死里复活以后，门徒就想起他说过所说的。
Verse 21, but he was speaking of the temple of his body. Verse 22, therefore, when he had risen from the dead, his disciples remembered that he had said this to them.
那门徒回想起来了。
And so the disciples were able to recollect.
那个门徒就传下去了。
And then the disciples subsequently preached.
所以使徒时代一开始啊,
and so at the beginning of the apostolic time,
开始有教会，开始有人受洗。
That there have been church and there have been people who were baptized.
使徒行传第二章第42节。
Let's turn to Acts chapter 2, verse 2.
42节。
Verse 42.
一天7000人受洗。
That in one day, 7,000 people were baptized.
42节,
verse 42.
他们做什么?
What did they do?
都恒心遵守使徒的教训。
That they continue steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine and fellowship.
使徒的教训。
It was the apostles' doctrines.
你不是说信耶稣吗？怎么会搞到使徒去了？
Aren't you believing Lord Jesus Christ? Why would it be according to the apostles?
因为使徒听过耶稣讲的，并且他们用生命的道讲出生命的道。
Because these the apostles had heard from Lord Jesus Christ, and then they were simply describing what the Lord had told them.
那这个道呢，到最后就集结起来。
But then these doctrines will at the end be collected.
所以我们看罗马书哈。
Let's turn to Romans.
罗马书就比较后面一点了哈。
The Roman had actually been a little bit more behind.
那我们看罗马书，我们看第六章。
Roman chapter 6.
罗马书第六章十七节。
Roman chapter 6 verse 17. Chapter 6 verse 17, but God be thanked that though you were slaves of sin, yet you obeyed from the heart that form of doctrine to which you were delivered.
这边说传给你们道理的规模。
And that you obey from your heart that form of doctrine.
他那边是换作 doctrine.
So it had been translated into doctrines here.
其实这个 dogma 这个是就是国王的命令皇上的，如果 以 dogma 来讲的话
in original context being the word dogma it would actually be the commandment from a king
耶稣有没有传教义啊
did Lord Jesus preach doctrines
没有啊
he didn't do so
传教训
he preached his teaching
圣经没有用 doctrine 或 dogma 来讲，但是到最后是集结成为一个规模。
And so the Bible never described them as dogma or doctrines, rather at the end it had been collected to be so.
那个提摩太后书第一章哈。
Let's turn to Second Timothy.
第十二十三节。
Second Timothy chapter 1.
一章提摩太后书一章十三节。
Second Timothy chapter 1 verse 13. Chapter 1, verse 13, hold fast the pattern of sound words which you have heard from me in faith and love which are in Jesus Christ.
所以这里有纯正话语的规模。
And so here is referred to the pattern of sound words.
所以这是教会的根基啊。
So these will be considered the foundations of the church.
这里用羔羊十二个使徒的名字来代表。
And that it had been represented by the names of the 12 disciples.
所以这个圣城是以教义、以真理、以得救的要道为基础的。
And so, the foundation of this entire holy city will be the righteousness, the words, and the grace of God.
如果没有的话
，if it's not to be the case,
到处都可以说这里是圣城。
Then, regardless where you go, you can say that this is the holy city.
所以。要进这个城，这个城要看这个是不是以真理来建造的。
And so to be able to enter into this holy city, you must first discern whether or not the city has been built upon the truth.
用主耶稣的话来讲
，and that it would be speaking the words of Lord Jesus.
你不经过水跟灵的重生，你不能见神的国。
That if you do not being reborn out of the water and the spirit, you cannot.See the kingdom of God.
你不从那个借着洗礼得圣灵，你不能进到神的国。
That if not through baptism and the washing of the Holy Spirit, then you cannot enter into the heavenly kingdom.
这个是对一般世人来讲很残忍的。
And for
他们认为很残忍。
Normal people, they would consider this to be rather cruel.
人家会问呢、啊，为什么你们只有真耶稣教会得救、啊？这个人、这些人头脑太奇怪了。
And、other people might ask, why would it be that only you, Jesus Church, can be saved? That you have such a strange thinking.
排斥啊！现在是怎么一个社会
？And it seems like you're ostracizing others. What kind of society are we living in right now?
这是一个多元的。
That we're in a multifaceted world.
这是一个开放的。
Very open-minded.
啊！你们还说你们是唯一得救，
rather,
把别人都排出去。
You say you are the only ones who are saved, and that you are ostracizing others.
问题不是这样问的。
But then the question is not to be this.
如果以我自己理性，我以个人来讲，
from my own logical perspective,
我最不喜欢讲这个。
I really do not like to talk about this.
但是这个不是我来决定的。
And this is not something for me to decide.
我希望说，你只要说啊，神存在就得救了。你我也希望说，每个人都得救了。为什么每个人都是神的儿女嘛？都是神创造的，大家快乐。
I also hope that as long as you believe in Lord Jesus, you can be saved. I want everybody to be saved as long as you believe.
甚至你不不信耶稣，你有良心，那神呢看你的良心，你也得救。
And even if you don't believe in Lord Jesus Christ and you have a good conscience, that you abide by your conscience, and you can still be saved.
因为神实在是太伟大了，神的伟大能够包含，能够那个容忍包含，并且赦免所有人的，无论你什么罪。所以全天下人，无论你怎么样的，条条道路都是通神呐。大家都得救了。
So,
最好是这样说。
God is so great and so wonderful that regardless what you believe in, you can still be saved because in all ways, all the path leads to heavenly kingdom. Of course, I wish that is the case.
那你心胸也开阔了。
If that is the case, then your entire heart will be opened up.
那全世界人都给你拍拍手嘛。
That everybody in this world will just applaud at your stance.
但是不是这样说的。
It is not to be said in this way.
这个圣城是天上掉下来的，好不好？
That this holy city had descended from heaven.
它就是这样规定的。
That the requirement would be such.
它就是根基，就是以圣经得救的要道。
That the foundation shall be the truth within the Bible.
这就有一个纯正话语的规模。
And that we have this.Pattern of sound words.
我们还不太敢，我们只是用保罗的话。保罗说，如果你传福音跟我的不一样，你就要被咒诅。
We can only deliver what Paul has said. That is, if you preach not according to what Paul had preached, then you will be cursed.
有够主观的吧？
Wouldn't this be very subjective?
其实不是的。
That's not the case.
因为这是从天掉下来的。
Because this had descended from heaven.
我们只是接受。
We only to accept.
所以得救。
If you are to be saved.
你有没有接受赦罪的洗礼？
Have you received the baptism for remission of sin?
这是白白给你的，你不接受，然后你，你不接受这个恩典，然后你想说我不接受这个恩典，我要闯进去。这太奇怪了吧。
And this has been given freely to you, but then you want to say that, oh, I don't want to receive that kind of grace. I want to just go in on my own term.
白白的应许了圣灵给你啊，免白白的给啊，你说我不要，但是呢，我会得救。这个很奇怪的。
This Holy Spirit
奇怪的是你啊。
Have been given freely to you, but then you say that I don't want that. In fact, I will be saved. Wouldn't this be very strange?
所以我们今天已经进到这里面来。
So today we had been able to enter into this.
这是很大的宝贵。
How precious it is.
这不是我们厉害。
It's not something that we had done, that we're so great.
这是恩典。
Rather, it is grace.
我们来唱诗。
Let us sing
him. 377首。陪你笼罩安
主赐力量，主常常顾念我，主常常顾念我，主常常顾念我，我不惊慌，主在身旁，主常常顾念我。无云我来，无云我去，今生或乐或多忧虑，我心满足，应有缺据，主常常顾念我，主常常顾念我，主常常顾念我，我不惊慌，主在身旁，主常常顾念我。
我们那个副歌就唱这个啊。
So we will sing the refrain later.
我们一起来祷告。
Kneel down, pray together.
那还不要再忘记那个今天早上我们所宣布的对那个弥迦姐妹祷告。
Forget the one we announced this morning. And pray for Melody Lu.
好，一起祷告。
哈利路亚，奉主耶稣基督圣名祷告。